Hello and welcome to the stream. Currently 55 degrees with it only getting colder as the night goes on. Tabor College Blue Jays are taking on Kansas Wesleyan here at home in Hillsboro, Kansas. Tabor College Blue Jays are currently 1-5, while K-Dub Eagles are 4-0. Like I said before, we're seeing one of our first winter games as the players are going to be playing through some colder weather here. Just a bit of humidity, a bit of the conditions make it a bit tougher on the players' joints, and just trying to see if they can get through the match tonight. Ryan and Evan are also going to be missing tonight's match through sickness or injury, so maybe some new faces in the starting lineup. Players are currently getting ready to line up down there on the sideline and get ready to get this match going. Currently on the screen, here are the records for the offseason and conference. Also, if we could get some prayers for Jordan Maska and Zachary Moore, who just went through ACL reconstruction surgeries recently, for a fast and full recovery. Kansas Wesleyan now finishing up their huddle as they're getting ready to line up as well. Now Kansas Wesleyan already looking at their record being 4-1 currently in conference. Probably going to be looking for a win here tonight. Blue Jays trying to turn the season around a little bit, see if they can pull a win out of here, a bit of a unexpected win.
Ladies and gentlemen, to tonight's KCAC Conference matchup between the Kansas Wesleyan Coyotes and your Tabor College Blue Jays. As a participant in the NAIA's Champions of Character Initiative, we, along with the Kansas Collegiate Athletic Conference,
challenge each of you to enjoy tonight's contest with a true sports spirit of sportsmanship. Tabor College is confident that this will create
a positive, more of a normal environment
we can all take pride in and enjoy.
These players are lining up out there on the field.
Would you please stand as I pray for tonight's game?
I think George Eli is going to be filling in for Evan tonight.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to come and compete in this great game of soccer. Lord, we just thank you for each one here. We just pray that you will keep both teams free from injury, help them to play to the best of their ability, give the officials wisdom and clarity in their judgment, and give us as fans the ability to cheer in a positive manner for our teams and not against our opponents. As we leave this evening, we pray for safety for our guests from Kansas Wesleyan and also our family here from Tabor as they travel home. We pray this in Jesus Christ. Amen. Kansas Wesleyan University men's soccer team, led by head coach Diego Cocoon, enters tonight's contest with a conference record of 4-0-1 and an overall record of 5-5-1. Let's meet the starting lineup for Kansas Wesleyan. First of all, in goal, number 98, Victor Andrade. Number 1, John David Garces. Excuse me, that's number 2. Number 3, Jose Rivera. Number 4, Jorge Mejia. Number 6, Oscar Palacios. Number 8, Christian Lima. Number 10, Yadier Rodriguez. Number 11, Radley Arnold. Number 12, Orfi Matafade. Number 18, Daniel Uzaya. Number 21, David Palacios. Tabor College men's soccer team, led by head coach Grant Brubaker, enters tonight's contest with a conference record of 1-5 and an overall record of 2-8-2. And now, let's meet to the starting lineup for your Tabor College Blue Jays. In goal, number 27, from Santa Clara, California, senior Derek Esslinger. From Andover, Kansas, a junior, number 3, Dane Peterson. Number 6, a junior from Peoria, Arizona, Tyler Combs. Hutchinson, Kansas, number 7, Cooper Allen. Number 8, from McPherson, Kansas, sophomore Darius Armstrong. From Brickyard, Florida, a junior, number 9, John Lee DeZol. From Montevideo, Uruguay, a junior, number 10, Federico Bove. Sophomore from Fort Worth, Texas, number 11, Colton Roundtree. A junior from Amarillo, Texas, number 14, George Zalea. From McPherson, the senior, number 22, Jeremy Crable. And the captain from Auckland, New Zealand, senior, number 26, Lewis Firminger.
All the players are shaking hands down there as the startings have just been announced. The Tabor College Blue Jays are actually going to go back in for a huddle. I think we're going to have some starting lineup overlays coming up soon. Just to go over this current starting lineup, here they are.
For the Coyotes, number 6 is Alex Ramos.
Here's the current lineup. Cooper Allen and John Lee. I also saw Federico Bove. We're going to be running that attack with Dane Peterson and Darius Armstrong sitting in at the fallback. So lots of attacking presence, as also Tyler Combs sitting back in the number 6, but seems they're going to be really pushing on to try and get the ball forward and see if they can build an attack here. Lots of pace, lots of talent in the starting lineup. There's Federico Bove. And then also Lewis Firminger and George Elias starting at center back. And so it seems Colton Roundtree, Jeremy Crable, and Tyler Combs are going to be the midfielders for tonight. There's in goal, Derek Esslinger. Just to talk a little bit more, it seems Colton Roundtree, usually starting on the wing this season, is going to be moved back, or I'm assuming he's going to be moved back into that midfield position as a central midfielder, playing alongside Jeremy Crable. Seeing them starting them, Colton Roundtree seems to actually be moving out to the right side. So maybe a 4-2-4 actually with Fed, John Lee, Cooper, and Colton all going to be running that attack. Bit of an interesting way to start it. Ball has been kicked off, and Kato, we're going to be holding this one nicely as they're just building possession here, giving their player some of the touches on the ball. K-Dub in, moving it far across to the wing, trying to keep this one in. Couldn't quite. It's going to be a Tabor College throw-in. Dane Peterson stepping up for this one. It's It's going to be a throw, trying to find deep for Cooper Allen, who's trying to maybe have that one slip over. Couldn't quite. Tyler Combs giving a nice ball to Colton Rountree, who tried to find Colton over the top. Didn't quite. It's going to be a free kick for Tabor College. George Zelaya, the one to take it on near the 50. Playing it across to his other center back. Tabor College are now back in possession here. And going to see if they can try and start something here. It's a nice little passing going on. Like I said before, the 4-2-4 seems to be the starting formation here. Tons of attacking pressure in that. Not much of a midfield presence, but tons of attacking pressure, tons of defensive. You can build a defensive stronghold because you still have the four in the back and the midfielder to drop. But it's a unique one because not too many teams run four up top. And at the same time, Cooper Allen and Colton Rountree can always drop off as midfield wingers and change it to a 4-4-2. But it seems as though they're committing pretty high up. K-Dub now back in possession. Playing a wide, bit of a miscommunication there. It's going to be a Tabor College throw. Pretty forward from where they started that play. Darius Armstrong to take this throw in. Giving it off to Lewis Firminger. He's trying to set up maybe an ambitious play there. He didn't quite get it off. It's going to be a deflection, though, off of the K-Dub forward. Darius Armstrong up for another throw-in. John Lee now. Back to Tyler Combs. Armstrong. Finding Cooper Allen with a great touch. Trying to hold on to this. Top of the box, trying to take a shot here. Takes a deflection off the K-Dub defender. Falls out for a K-Dub counterattack. Ford has paced his defender now. He's moving down the line. Tons of speed here. Tries to get a whip in. Didn't quite have the numbers that they wanted there. Tyler Combs. Not the greatest touch there. Lewis Firminger able to make a clearance on that ball. K-Dub showing their counterattacking presence as they say, you know, you make one mistake, we're going to take advantage of it and we're going to go for it. Doing a great job of pushing out to that outside wing. Not quite having the delivery correct. I think he had two players back post and try to see if he could find something top of the box. Lewis Firminger now stepping up for the free kick. That was called for Federico Bove. Lewis hitting this one deep into John Lee, who tried to get something here. Didn't quite. John, I think, thought maybe it took a hit off the defender. Ref is going to call a goal kick. Goal kick is hit deep and takes a nice little hit. K-Dub almost starting a brilliant attack there as it almost slipped through the defenders. George Zelaya was able to make the clearance, though. I think a call for offsides has been called, though. Derek Eslinger going to be taking this free kick. Playing it short to George Zelaya. Who knows he's in time. And he's in space and he's got time. Just going to hold on to this one. Finding Cooper Allen. Into Jeremy Crable. He's moving forward now. Finds Federico on the through. Slips it past. Federico in the front. And it goes in for Tabor College goal. John Lee. Federico Bove slipping into John Lee. I think he put it. Fantastic slip through. Federico Bove. Starting the attack. George Zelaya able to slip it to Cooper Allen. I think laid it off for Jeremy Crable. Got a brilliant ball into Federico Bove. Here's a replay of that. There was the ball to Federico Bove. Slips it just right across the front. John Lee able to get a little touch and hitting the outside post and going in. K-Dub trying to kick this one off quickly. on another day. Sometimes those just don't go in. I think the keeper might have thought it might have been a bit wide of his post. Bit misguessed. Tabor College now 1-0 in a little bit over 5 minutes of this match. Jeremy Crable now. K-Dub regaining possession. Taking the deflection off of Tyler Combs. It's going to be cleared. It's now a throw-in for K-Dub. Team's Tabor College is going to be sitting back on this one. Not pressuring too high. Just sitting in and making sure they can have the numbers when they need it. In that attacking third against K-Dub. K-Dub still just playing around the back. Now trying to slip it over and trying to find a winger. Dane Peterson trying to challenge here. George Elia. Foul's going to be called. It's going to be a free kick. Here on the 20. I think Derek Eslinger is going to be the one to take it. Oh, excuse me, on the 15. George Lye able to win the defensive header. K-Dub now trying to build something here, almost finding the forward there. Lewis Firminger is stepping up quickly. This could be a K-Dub throw-in now. Playing it short, K-Dub. Just being held in their half currently by Tabor College. With these amazing hits and passes trying to build an attack. Tyler Combs, huge through. Trying to find John Lee over the top. He's able to take a touch. He's taking it to the corner flag. He's going to be holding on to this one. He's going to let it go. It's going to be a corner kick now for Tabor College. Fantastic hit over the top. I believe by Tyler Combs to find John Lee. He's able to hold it up and even catch a deflection off of the K-Dub defender to get a corner kick for his team. Federico Bove, the set-piece specialist now. Hitting this one in for the corner. Didn't quite find Tabor College shirt. It's going to be Jeremy Crable swinging it across. Darius Armstrong tries to get a whip in. Couldn't quite find his target. It's going to be it's cleared off of the K-Dub defender, though. It's going to be a throw-in for Tabor College. Darius Armstrong. Down the wing, trying to see if he can find Cooper Allen. It's going to be another throw for Tabor College. Darius Armstrong looked again for Cooper Allen. Couldn't quite reach that one. It's going to be a goal kick now for K-Dub. Playing it short. Just find one of his center backs. Or excuse me, I guess one of the fullbacks. Playing it deep now. K-Dub trying to build something here. Trying to hit it down the line. Winger couldn't quite reach it. It's going to be out for a Tabor College throw. Dane Peterson now. To George Zelaya. Tyler Combs. Trying to find Dane Peterson. Didn't quite. It's going to hit off of the K-Dub player. Dane Peterson now. Slipped through Cooper Allen. Trying to pick up a straggler. As it took a deflection off of the K-Dub defender. Couldn't quite. It's going to be another throw, though, for Tabor College. A little bit up the field now. Dane Peterson is the man to take the throw-in. Slipping it over the top. John Lee trying to find Cooper maybe over the top there. Going to Roundtree. Back to Tyler. Big switch to Federico Bove. Seems Federico Bove has gone down. It's going to be a free kick for Tabor College at about the 20. Means it's about 30 yards out from goal. Federico Bove setting this one down. Now in training, you know, Federico Bove is usually not scared to try and take one of these. He's got a cannon of a leg. So we might see maybe a shot on target here. Federico Bove trying to put it to the front post. Got it over the wall. Keeper did a great job of just bringing it down and putting it back in his possession. Playing it short into one of his center backs. K-Dub is now back in possession of the ball. And just taking advantage of Tabor College, not really putting on the high pressure here. They're okay just to sit back. Huge ball over the top, trying to find a winger. Dane Peterson able to a bit of a controversial thing here. I believe they thought it was going to be more of a foul. Ref's going to be talking to the number 10 for K-Dub. Dane Peterson up for the throw-in. Over the top. Cooper Allen trying to see if he can read these on the bounce. Not quite. K-Dub now back in their defense. Using a lot of these, I think they have a lot of trust in these wingers to really outpace the back line, and seeing that every time K-Dub are holding it, they usually get it to about the midfield line and then are very confident about the release to try and find one of those wingers to slip it over the top or at least find a through to one of their wingers who's able to build an attack. Not too many direct attacks so far. Tyler Combs is going to be called on a foul here. K-Dub now with a free kick. Player's gone down. I think they're going to be bringing a trainer on. But like I was saying, K-Dub really trying to use the take advantage of their wingers and their pace to try and get by and ultimately build an attack from there. Like we saw when they countered, they took it to the wide and got the service to inside the box. Couldn't quite find a target, but still lots of trust in these wingers as the game progresses. Just a word from our sponsor, Paul Brooks, State Farm Insurance. Contact Paul for all your life, home, car insurance and more at 2121 North Tyler, Wichita, Kansas. For solutions to all your storage needs with proper security measures, go to Fleming's Mini Store All in Hillsboro, 407 South Dade Street in Hillsboro. And give meaning to money, the Mennonite Brethren Foundation at 200 East D Street, Hillsboro, Kansas. Thank you, guys. Trainer here, still just checking out to see if player's all right. Seems like a leg or knee injury, not too much in the ankle. Or no, maybe he's pointing down at his a little bit above the ankle. Maybe just taking a bit of a hit there on that challenge. It seems Tyler might have maybe come in and hit that, thinking he hit the ball or something there in that challenge. He's a replay of that. Tyler just going down. I see he might have been something there. Yeah, I believe it. Or it seems. Looks like the player's right leg. Bit hard to see on that angle because it seemed a bit more squared off against the camera. Here's another look at the goal here. John Lee tapping it away to get to the back post. And then here's a goal attempt from Federico Bove. Trying to make something from 30 yards out. Good strike from the player. Good hands from the keeper on that one. With a little over 10 minutes have been played now. Tabor College 1-0 currently. For anyone checking in and wondering what's going on, a player is still currently getting checked out right now. Just making sure everything's all right. Might be a bit of an expert on the leg injuries. I've had a couple of my own. Just thoughts and prayers, and hopefully it's nothing too serious. Player's back up. He's going to be hanging off the sideline.
In for the Coyotes, number 7, Eliel Trejo.
Seems Michelle Pinay is the number 10 that's going to be heading off here. Thoughts and prayers. Hopefully it's nothing too serious for the player. Play is going to continue now. Kate up on the free kick. Sending it in deep with a goal immediately off of the play. Getting a header and putting it to the bottom corner. Derek not able to get a touch to it. It's now 1-1 here in Hillsboro. Tabor College now. It's going to be a free kick for Tabor College. Sending it deep, trying to find Colton Roundtree on a run here to the outside. Not quite hit with enough weight. Tabor College now in possession. K-Dub now. Moving this forward. K-Dub back in possession again. Jeremy Crable now. Trying to find John Lee. Trying to find Cooper Allen on the flick. Didn't quite. It's going to be a free kick back. I think maybe a bit of a trip back there. Jeremy Crable seemed to have gone down. It's going to be a free kick here. George Elia going to be taking it. K-Dub successfully clearing that free kick and starting a counter here. The forward almost going solo there, moving forward. Tabor College, though, back in possession here. Moved wide for Federico Bove. It's going to be a throw-in now for K-Dub. K-Dub with an ambitious ball over the top to try and find a winger there. Derek Eslinger is going to let just roll out. It's going to be a goal kick now. Derek Eslinger sending it deep. K-Dub now moving forward. Tons of attacking pressure here, and they got the numbers moving forward. Cutting it back and taking it back. Just trying to rebuild something here. It's going to be a foul. K-Dub with the free kick. Taking it quickly. Moving it around. Moving it wide to the wing, who's now found some space here. Trying to whip this one in. Maybe a bit, trying to add a bit more curve to it. It's going to fall over the crossbar. Derek Eslinger now with the goal kick. Federico Bove into Crable, who tried to get forward to John Lee. K-Dub now. Holding possession here. Just moving this around nicely. Now in the midfield, tons of... These triangles, passing triangles being formed. Lots of splits, lots of nice passing here from K-Dub. Huge ball over the top to the winger, who's able to get by his man. Tries to slip a top box. Maybe not on the same page. Didn't quite see that one. K-Dub, though, now back in possession, cutting the counterattack out. It's going to be K-Dub now back in possession, moving this run. Huge ball again over the top. Trying to find this winger. Keeps it in. Trying a bit of a footwork there, trying to get by. Didn't quite come off. It's going to be a throw-in for K-Dub. Winger trying to go on his own. See if he can set up a chance for service. Federico Bove now getting a bit of a talking to. Ref just making sure he can stay in control here. Oh, it seems a player has gone down. Not sure what happened. Colton Roundtree seems to be down. Not sure what's going on here. A replay here. Colton Roundtree. Is Colton going down? Not sure what happened. Seems he's gone. Is he back up, I think? Back on that back post? Yep, that is him. Conor Autry back. He's back up. Michael Colley, the third, seems to be warming up a little bit down on that line. K-Dub John Cooper Allen finding. Hits a cut it out, trying to find Federico Bove now. It's going to be K-Dub's throwing. Ball sent long. Louis Firminger, first responder here. We have a free kick. Seems the call has been against Colton Rountree. It's going to be a free kick now for K-Dub. Playing it deep. Finding the K-Dub forward's feet. Trying an ambitious hit from there. Making the contact on the ball, not quite finding the precision though. Derek Eslinger now with the goal kick. With 20 minutes now being played. Grable now. To Bove. Back to Allen. Great stop from the K-Dub defender. Tyler Combs able to shut down or cut out that pass, though. Finding a wide to Colton Rountree now. Finds John Lee. John Lee not able to quite make the touch to retain possession there, though. Still blocks the hit, though. It's going to be a throw-in for K-Dub. K-Dub. Now in possession. Moving it wide. Into tons of space here. Looking at the other winger, trying to see if they can find something here. Colton Rountree, though. It'll get a touch to it and slow down the counterattack. K-Dub now. In possession here at the top of the box. Almost getting a nice little flick on to lay it off. K-Dub still in possession here. It's not going to be hit deep. Derek Eslinger going to be able to get a touch to that. I think Derek might have clipped the K-Dub winger. Didn't seem like it was intentional. I think he had a few words exchanged there. K-Dub now trying to slip this over the top. Finding the winger. Nice little flick on. Not quite, though. It's going to be a corner, I believe, for K-Dub. K-Dub now setting up. Trying to find something front post. Making contact. Not quite the contact he wanted, though. It's going to be Derek Eslinger now for a goal kick. Tolan Roundtree flicking it on, trying to find Cooper Allen. Huge hit to the back post. Winger tries to find something. Darius Armstrong, though, making the defensive clearance. Could be a throw-in for K-Dub. It's going to be a goal kick. I think the K-Dub forward went down, thinking he could maybe draw a penalty there. Enough points for the goal kick. It's going to be Derek Eslinger now. A bit over 20 minutes left of this half now. Still tied 1-1. Seems the card is going to be awarded now to Federico Bove. Not sure what happened there. Free kick now for K-Dub. There's a bit of a replay on that. You can see back there. Takes his shoulder. I think a player just unnecessarily shouldered Federico, and Federico then unnecessarily clipped the ankle to make him trip. Ball's whipped in. Almost finding a K-Dub player to maybe catch a deflection in the net. Derek Eslinger stays strong, though, and is able to catch that one before it got too serious. K-Dub doing a great job of winning these set pieces and doing a great job of using these set pieces to make a very dangerous-looking attack. Also getting their first goal from a set piece. K-Dub now back in possession. Just holding this ball now. Finally trying to find something over the top. See if they can find a winger there. Takes an unlucky hit. It's going to fall to K-Dub forward as he's moving towards the front of the box. Didn't quite. Crable now in possession for Tabor College. Hit over the top. Bit too deep. It's going to go out for a goal kick. K-Dub now flicking this one on, trying to find their winger. He's got a touch to it. Lewis Firminger able to get a touch to that and clear it out. Still in K-Dub possession here as he's approaching top of the box. Tries a shot. Derek Eslinger not quite able to keep the hands on it. Dane Peterson doing a great job tracking his man and keeping him boxed out from that. Derek Eslinger get positioned to move forward on that and catch the ball. Flicked on Cooper Allen. Not quite able to get it over. It's going to be K-Dub now moving forward. Taking a deflection there. Might clip the ankle a bit. Players, I think maybe a card should be awarded. I think the player that went down might be coming off here. Number 11 for number 17. Or maybe just retaping a shin guard or something. Taken now, Derek Eslinger coming out with some fists. Bove now. Trying to move forward on that one. Couldn't quite. It's going to be K-Dub free throw-in. Excuse me. Grable now on the ball. Trying to find an option here. Dane Peterson. Moving it wide to Colton Roundtree. Up the line. Over the top for John Lee. Now he's trying to find the inside. Taking the shot on. Not quite able to keep it on frame. It's going to go wide. At the front post. Michael Cauley. Michael Cauley now subbing on for Federico Bove. New left mid now. He's going to transition, trying to see if he can keep the pressure on like Federico Bove was. See if he can help build another attack. K-Dub now. Swinging this one long and trying to find on the wide. Dane Peterson up for the challenge as well. Able to win it. Seems it's come off of Dane Peterson. Throw in now for Kiddo. About 30 minutes have been played now in this half. Kiddo are trying to find another potential attack here. It's now a throw in. K-Dub whipping it in. Dane Peterson able to make the clearance, though. K-Dub midfielder just holding it here. Colton Roundtree to find Cooper Allen, who's going to try and find John Lee on the run here. K-Dub able to make the attack, though. Holding possession here. K-Dub. Oh, excuse me, Tabor College now with the throw-in. Darius Armstrong, the one to take it. Trying to find John Lee there. Michael Cauley again trying to find John Lee. George Delay missing the header. It's now going to be a 2-on-2. Slip through to the winger, who's now found himself in space. K-Dub moving it forward, trying to find the back post option. Tabor College able to deal with it defensively. Having the numbers against them. K-Dub now back in possession here. K-Dub just holding this one off. Trying to see if they can rebuild another attack. K-Dub slowly moving forward up the field here. Still maintaining lots of possession, whipping it in. Trying to find the forward, Lewis Firminger able to catch it and clear it though. K-Dub now near top of the box, taking the shot from quite a ways out. It's going to go over the bar. Lots of power. Again, not quite the precision he quite wanted on that. Still made the contact, though. Derek now. On the goal kick, trying to find Jeremy Crable out on the wing. It's going to be a throw for Tabor College. John Lee now. Jeremy Crable, who's showing a bit of footwork here. Trying to get past some of the players. It's going to be another throw-in for Tabor College. Throw-in for Tabor College. Quite deep now in the half. Trying to make something happen here. Darius Armstrong, the man to take the free kick. Or excuse me, the throw-in. Trying to find target here. Couldn't quite Crable, able to catch a straggler. Dane Peterson to whip it in back post. John Lee trying to go up for that. Foul is going to be called against John Lee here. Probably seem to be a bit confused of what the call was. Life is explaining it to John Lee. Another player we see down on the sideline. Number 21, Steve, is going to be coming in. Oh, he plays a midfield position. Not really sure who he's going to be coming in for. Another foul call. It's going to be a free kick for K-Dub. And like we've seen, they're already very dangerous on these set pieces. Whipping it wide. Getting ready to try and make something here. Jeremy Crable trying to put a body in. Couldn't quite. Colton Roundtree able to get ahead to it. Move it forward. K-Dub with a foot on it. Top of the box. Trying to take a shot from there. Didn't quite reach. Aiming for the far post top corner. Not quite, though. Seems Cooper Allen's going to be the one to come off for Steve. Steve going on as a forward here. I don't think we've seen Steve Innocent here in a forward position on the home field yet. Let's see if he can really make a... Oh, looks like Jeremy Crable's gone down. Bit of an issue. No foul. It's going to be a throw-in for Tabor College. But like I was saying about Steve Innocent, not being seen here in the forward position, it's every forward's dream to get there. Their first goal in the first match. So maybe if he can find something here. K-Dub moving it forward. Lewis Firminger able to get up for that. Dane Peterson passing it back to Tarek Eslinger. It's going to find the top of the box. Jeremy Crable able to get it out. Big shot again. Not quite able to find the target. Derek Eslinger with the goal kick. Lots of attacking paralysis there for K-Dub as a couple of misfortunate events happening and moving the ball forward, taking advantage of them, almost leading to another goal. It's going to be K-Dub now back in possession. whipping this one forward, trying to find over the top. Dane Peterson able to clear that one out. Player still in possession here at top of the box. Michael Cawley able to clear it out. John Lee now able to make the challenge here. Foul now for Tabor College. It's going to be a free kick here. George Elias stepping up to take the free kick. It's a little over 5 minutes remaining now. Excuse me, a little over 6 minutes remain. K-Dub able to deal with the ball. Whipped in, Lewis Firminger. Or excuse me, Tyler Combs is going to be the one to take that. On the volley, trying to get something a bit special there. Didn't quite make the contact he wanted there. It's going to be K-Dub's possession now. George Elias able to catch this one and clear it forward. Not quite able to keep it in for John Lee, but still moved forward. It's going to be a throw-in now for K-Dub. Dane Peterson making contact, but not able to move it forward. It's going to be another throw-in now for K-Dub. K-Dub now moving forward. Foul's going to be called. I think a bit of the players aren't happy with that. I think the player might have gone down a little bit too easy. It's going to be a free kick now for K-Dub. About 35 yards out. Maybe a shot being seen here from the K-Dub player. Whipping it into a very dangerous position there. Derek Eslinger able to get a fist to it. Clear it out. Steve with a huge hit to stop that. George Elias trying to find Jeremy Crable. It's now to Cawley. Crable now trying to whip this one forward to Colton Roundtree. He's able to win this one back. Still on it. It's now K-Dub. He's now trying to find a winger here. Darius Armstrong able to cut that one out. Tried to slip it through to Steve Innocent there. Not quite. It's going to be K-Dub now. Just a little over 3 minutes now of the half remaining. Derek Eslinger now in possession of the ball. Michael Cawley with a nice touch there. K-Dub now. Slipping this one through. George Elias in the forward in a bit of a foot race. Bit of a competition there. It's going to be a corner. K-Dub now with maybe one of the last set pieces of this half. Getting ready for the corner. Ball gets whipped in. Close to the back post, not quite. Kate, I'm still having it here. Steve Instead able to put it out. And it's going to be another corner now for K-Dub. K-Dub finding an option, which is the corner of the box, getting a hand to it. Derek Eslinger to get a fist to it. Bit of the commentator's curse. I thought the first corner was going to be one of the last set pieces. Now we've seen the third corner in a row here. For K-Dub, a little under 2 minutes now. Whipped in, it seemed not to have made contact with almost anyone. Derek Eslinger now with a goal kick. John Lee able to win this one. Nice little move to get by the player. It's going to be cleared out by the K-Dub defender. Tabor College now trying to build an attack here. Darius Armstrong now. George Zelaya. Finding one to Dade Peterson, who almost whips it over. He's calling around tree. It's going to be K-Dub now. Foul for K-Dub now. Or free kick, excuse me. A little under 30 seconds now. K-Dub sets up for this free kick. Whipped in now. Derek Eslinger showing no hesitation coming out from as soon as it was kicked. Steve Innocent. I'm going to get a touch on it before it falls out. It's going to be a throw in now. 10 seconds left. Ball's cleared out. It's going to be another K-Dub throw, but I think they're going to give it. It's going to be the first half completed here in Hillsboro, Kansas. The end result of 1-1. That's Tabor College Blue Jays getting ready to start the second half against K-Dub Coyotes. Thank you guys for coming out to the stream. About 15 minutes, we'll be back to start the second half.
wish you could stop me. Nobody's blowing that candle. Watch how I rock on the sleep. You better bring your pajamas. Look how he's slipping and falling. I got him going bananas. I got an ankle bully graveyard. Give me your ankles to bury you. This is an ankle murder under investigation. Y'all gotta guess who did it. The ankle bully was playing. You better take him and lace him. I like to shake him and break him. Straight to the hole, I'ma take him. Already know I'ma make it. Because I'm an ankle bully. You need your ankle braces. Run from that ankle bully. Cause I'm out here ankle breaking. You know I'm an ankle bully. So don't get your ankles taken.
That was another fantastic song here on Game Time. The product of athletics is not wins and championships. It's the development of lifetime values and respect for the game. Please join us in showing your good sportsmanship and respect for those who play, coach, and officiate these events, and help those lessons extend beyond this game and into the classrooms and our daily lives. Time for more great tunes here on Game Time.
Create an estate plan that values what you value. The Biblical Estate Design Service from MB Foundation is a will planning service that brings your faith into the process of preparing a God-honoring estate plan. Many donors of Tabor College have used this service to create their plan and have chosen to leave a gift to the college, a gift that will have a lasting impact on future generations of Tabor students. Learn more at mbfoundation.com/Tabor and get started on your plan today.
MB Foundation, giving meaning to money.
Think about how good it feels when people really get you. Like the friends who come over when a big game is on, the neighbors next door who always bring your favorite buffalo dip, your in-laws who know you need silence during the clutch plays, and everyone who knows about your special post-win fist bump. It's kind of like having a State Farm agent like Paul Brooks. Paul is here to get to know you and understand your life, so he can help make it easy for you to protect what's important. Get an agent that gets you and your fist bumps. Call State Farm agent Paul Brooks in Wichita at 316-721-8181.
It's a powerful combination. The Tabor College Blue Jays and Game Time.
You in the eye and hesitated when I asked if you were alright. Seems like you're fighting for your life, but why? Oh, why? Wide awake in the middle of your nightmare.
another great song here on Game Time. Blue Jay fans, we thank you for joining us here today. Tabor College believes that Christ-centered competition is healthy for all involved. When Christ is at the center of all we do, we all win. More music is coming up here on Game Time.
This is all of the Blue Jays.
They're like amazing.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome to Tabor College.
There were the highlights for the first half. We're now starting the second half here as Tabor College Blue Jays are going to be kicking off. Here we go. Grable trying an ambitious ball off the start. It's Federico Bove, not quite. I think a change in the mid during the halftime seemed to be Colton Rountree off for Federico Bove. I think that's the only change that, and Cooper Allen's back on. It's not going to be a throw-in quite deep inside the K-Dub. The K-Dub half now, starting off the second half. Darius Armstrong, the one to take it, trying to find Cooper Allen here. Almost finding another target, but now Lewis Firminger trying to make something of it. K-Dub now just clearing it out. It's going to be another throw-in for Tabor College. Michael Collie trying to whip this one in. Not quite. It's going to fall out. Is that going to be a goal kick for K-Dub? K-Dub now. Still in possession here. Playing it around the defense, trying to get some touches here. Maybe even trying to warm up some of the bodies down there since it's pretty cold down there. Jeremy Cribble able to intercept that pass to John Lee, who's now in the middle, top of the box. Tries to put it down. The keeper gets a good hand to it. Early chance here for Tabor College, with Jeremy Crable making a great interception in their half. He's able to find John Lee. Puts a shot on target. Michael Colley going to be clearing this one out. It's going to be a K-Dub throw. Lewis clearing it out. It's going to be a K-Dub throw. Or excuse me, a Tabor College throw. It's going to be another throw for Tabor College here. It's a replay on that of John Lee almost getting another one here. Nice movement there to go to the outside and try and shoot far post. Not quite able to pull it off, though, as the keeper did a very great job of making that save there, getting a hand to it. This is going to be Darius Armstrong trying to defend this one. K-Dub forward almost getting through. Could be a K-Dub throwing now. Ball whipped in deep. Finding Derek Eslinger's hands. Derek Eslinger punting this one far. John Lee's able to get the touch and slip it to Federico Bove now. Tries to get one back. John Lee still. Ball's going to come out now for a Tabor College throw. Darius Armstrong. Ball played down the line, trying to find John Lee. K-Dub just taking it easy and playing it out. It's going to be a Tabor College throw-in, a little bit up the line now. Cooper Allen now. Lewis Firminger. Just clearing it out. It's going to be a K-Dub throw-in now. Playing it deep, trying to find the winger here. Take the touch, not quite the one he wanted. It's going to be a goal kick now. Luis Firminger playing it out. It's going to be a throw-in now. K-Dub looking for an opening here. Going down the wing. Getting a nice little through pass there. It's going to be an offsides call. Tabor College now with the free kick. Darius Armstrong now with the throw-in. Luis Firminger trying to step up on this one. K-Dub still in possession here. K-Dub now in possession here. Not a lot going for either way currently. So just moving it around now here in the midfield. Big switch, but Dane Peterson able to catch that one. It's going to be a K-Dub throwing now. K-Dub trying to build something here, whipping it in, finding the target, and finding the header to put it away back post. K-Dub now 2-1 in a little under 10 minutes of this second half. Number 3 winning the header, able to put it to the back post. Tabor College now, the next 35 minutes, trying to see if they can get another one back here. Here's another look at it. Whipped in, able to find the striker's head and get it to that back post. Foul here. Tabor College, free kick. Tyler comes, the one to step up for this free kick now. Bring this one into the back post. Not quite able to find the header. Luis Firminger almost getting contact on that to put it away. Goal kick taken short and quickly. K-Dub now. Playing it through, trying to find a forward. Darius Armstrong able to put it forward. Okay, I'm taking the free kick quickly. Going wide. Trying to see if they can build something right here. Michael Colley able to stop that very deadly looking pass. It's gonna be a throw in for Tabor College. Darius Armstrong playing it long. Maybe a missed throw there. I think it's going to be Kate-up throwing now. Oh, the ball seemed to come back out. Michael Colley able to get her header on that. It's going to be a Kate-up throwing. Kate up now. In possession here.
Can they hold it like on the side for the whole game if they want to?
Kate up moving forward now. Huge hit, trying to see if he can catch the keeper off his line. Could be a goal kick for Tabor College here. Cooper Allen now. It's going to be a free kick. Foul called on the K-Dub defender. Yellow card also awarded. Have a shoving match now going on down there. Federico Bove and Lewis Firminger stepping up for this free kick. No, I actually think Lewis is going to be the one. Kato having a four-man wall here. Seeing a bit of a goal threat from this far out. Ball gone out. It's going to be a goal kick for K-Dub.
Big dog. Oh, man. Mark, you got me. Bring me an extra coat up here.
K-Dub still in possession here, slipping it to the top of the box. Making something here, trying to slip it through. Beat his man. Derek with huge hands able to catch that cross. K-Dub really putting on a dangerous attack there. As that K-Dub winger showing he has the pace to beat his man. Not quite able to slip it past Derek though. Tabor College now in possession. He's now look at it. As he slips through here. Almost getting something on that number three. Again, who's shown he can score with his head.
I feel like I'm getting
that was going to be called. Steve Innocent again stepping up to the line. Maybe to move back into that striker position. George Elias stepping up for this free kick. Whipped in, not quite able to find Tabor head. K-Dub. Now have the counter here. K-Dub now. Finding the winger. Moving to the inside. Tabor College in possession here. Trying to find this back post almost on Federico's run. K-Dub winger able to keep this one in. Going for the Meg. Darius able to keep it away. Still going to be a corner, though, for K-Dub. Now trying to defend the set piece here. Get up now with a throw in. Steve Innocent coming out in for John Lee. Cooper Allen's going to be the one to stay on this time. Throwing now for K-Dub.
It was still cold going in the spring break. Yes. Immediately.
K-Dub now in possession. Whipped over the top, Michael Cauley. Trying to make sure the defender doesn't get it. Plays the ball out. It's going to be a throw in now. For K-Dub. Letting the ball roll out. It's going to be a goal kick now for Derek Eslinger. Here's Derek Eslinger. Ball being moved around here. K-Dub now back in possession. It's going to be a throw-in now for K-Dub. K-Dub. Near top of the box. Still trying to make an attack here. So just moving around, looking to build something here.
Tell him he gotta learn at some point in time, baby.
Whipped wide and long, trying to find that other winger. Not quite on the same page, though. Derek Eslinger is gonna let it roll back to his box, pick it up. Dane Peterson now. It's going to be a throw in now. Dane Peterson stepping up to take it in. George Zelaya. It's Verminger. Back to Zelaya. Playing it long and wide, trying to find Bova here. On the wide, though. K-Dub. K-Dub defender doing a great job shielding that ball so that Federico Bova wasn't able to get a touch to it. K-Dub now.
What is you thinking?
You're in possession. Tabor College now.
They be swinging that boy.
Darius Armstrong playing it out. Get up throwing now. K-Dub winger still doing a great job of holding this ball here. It's gonna be a goal kick here.
Chill, y'all don't need to score anymore. Oh yeah.
K-Dub now. Darius Armstrong playing it out, playing it safe. It's gonna be a K-Dub throw in now. A little over 20 minutes now, remaining in the half. Score line is still 2-1. Whipping it in, trying to find something in the back post. Another ball whipped in. Didn't quite find a head. Crable now. K-Dub still in possession here. Trying to take the shot on the tight angle. Derek Eslinger able to catch the ball. Getting ready to punt it forward. Crable now. Okay, though, back in possession here. Steve Innocent now. Trying to win this one here. It's going to be a free kick here for Tabor College.
Ooh. Watch it.
Federico Bove now, whipping this one in. Not able to find the target. K-Dub now trying to start an attack here on the counter. Moving forward. Finding the winger nicely. Has service into the box, nobody really there. Except they picked it up at the back post. Crable now. Able to stop anything on the front post before it got a bit too dangerous there. Now Steve Innocent starting the counter. Foul called now. George Zelaya, I believe, is going to be the one to take this. Jeremy Crable with a nice little run there. Also pulling off that roulette, or attempted a roulette, almost pulling it off before getting fouled at the end. A little under 20 minutes now. Ball about to be whipped in. It's going to fall to the keeper, who's now back in possession for K-Dub. Federico Bove. The tie comes back. Federico finds. Just a bit of passing going around here. Tabor College are back in possession here. Armstrong. Comes to Darius. It's going to be off the K-Dub defender. Two players we see warming up down the sideline. Colton Roundtree and John Lee. Getting ready to see if they can change this game. George Zelaya now. To Peterson. Oh no. Firminger. Playing along. Keeper back in possession of the ball now. After Lewis has attempted over the top through. Playing it deep now. Jeremy Crable. Bit mad that he didn't get to play advantage there. I think the ref was trying to call advantage. Set the play going a little bit south. Decided to bring it back. It's going to be George Zelaya now stepping up for the free kick. Whipped into the back post. Crable now, trying to find a straggler here. Ball's going to be cleared out, though. Derek Eslinger stepping quite a ways out of his box to come meet that ball. Played long, but a bit too far. K-Dub now back in possession. A little over 15 minutes remain. This second half, K-Dub 2, Tabor 1. Foul now. Tabor College with the free kick. Federico Bove seems to be the one stepping up for this one. Federico Bove with the service in. Finding Lewis, but huge clearance from the defender to catch that one. Don't think the keeper was quite ready for it. Kida playing it down the wing, trying to keep it in. Not quite. Ball's going to be called back. They called advantage, I think, on that. It's going to be a free kick back here for K-Dub. Tyler comes going a bit too hard into the challenge to the referee's liking. K-Dub now. Booting this forward, trying to find the winger on the outside. Darius able to make the clearance out the sideline. It's going to be a thrown in now for K-Dub, quite deep inside the half. Steve Innocent and Federico Bove stepping off now as Colton Roundtree and John Lee now step back in. George Elia clearing the ball. Dane Peterson just letting it go. It's going to be a throw in now for K-Dub. Service into the box. Derek Eslinger able to get contact on it. Played long now. It's going to be a foul now. Free kick for Tabor College. George Elias setting it down, playing it quickly. Finding wide, Darius Armstrong now. And a bit of space. Huge ball played. Derek Eslinger still quite far out of the box to make the clearance. Derek not quite able to make the full contact. I think Lewis Firminger did, though.
He's a savage.
It's going to be a throw in here for Tabor College. Another throw in for Tabor College, a bit up the line. John Lee now.
You see the footwork? You see the footwork?
Played long. Trying to find the forward again. This Firminger is just going to let Derek Eslinger have it there. Crable now. Michael Colley the third. Playing, trying to find down line. John Lee now. Foul is going to be called. Bench quite upset with that call. It's going to be a free kick now for K-Dub. K-Dub now. Mm. K-Dub winning another free kick here. It's about 10 minutes remaining in this half.
Is it me or did it get cold?
It's going to be K-Dub here. George Lyon now with the throw-in. Or excuse me, Darius Armstrong. Or excuse me, Dane Peterson actually taking the throw-in here. Comes to Michael Cauley. Substitute trying to find John Lee on the run there. Ball's going to be played wide. Tabor College throw now. Darius Armstrong. Slips past, trying to find the back post. Keeper able to make the save on the tight angle. John Lee almost finding the back of the net. Great hands from the keeper, though. Ball slipped through, trying to find the winger. K-Dub now. Whipped it in. Derek Eslinger gets a punch to it. Still near the top of the box. Still inside the goalie's box. K-Dub, another ball in. Didn't find a target in the box. K-Dub still in possession here. It's going to be out for a corner. Substitution, Steve Innocent back up on the line. Cooper Allen coming off for Steve Innocent. Or no, sorry, Cooper Allen staying on. Michael Cauley the third coming out for Steve Innocent. K-Dub now with a corner. Derek Eslinger getting a foot to it, clearing it out. It's going to be another corner now. This half coming to a close very soon. Tabor still looking to get one more, put them back in this game. Derek Eslinger now. Cooper Allen now. It's going to be a K-Dub throw. Darius Armstrong clearing it up. Foul now. Yellow card awarded. Not sure if that was for Cooper Allen or for the player. Be a bit interesting if it was for Cooper Allen. I didn't see contact. I think number four from K-Dub actually might have gotten the yellow card there. Derek Eslinger now. Grable now. Darius Armstrong. Top of the box. Tyler Combs now. Trying to find something. Cooper Allen. Not quite. Two chances at the top of the box. Couldn't quite keep them on frame. It's going to be a goal kick now for K-Dub. But out of bounds. Tabor College is going to get a throw in here, trying to find John Lee quickly. Five minutes now remaining. K-Dub making the clearance. There's Firminger touching it down for Darius Armstrong. K-Dub switching the ball. K-Dub now with the numbers and on this counter. Taking a shot now. Wide of the back post. It's going to be a goal kick. I think a yellow card for Dane Peterson. Playing back on the earlier challenge. Might have been George or Dane there. Foul called. Not sure what's going on there. I think the player might have gone to ground, not knowing he already won the free kick. K-Dub trying to take the shot from inside the box. Derek Eslinger picks it up. Not quite the contact the player wanted. K-Dub now in possession here. If you was here, how would you be?
That song will make you cry though.
Dane Peterson clearing the ball up the line. I think linesman called it out though. It's going to be a throw in back there. Or excuse me, free kick. Derek Eslinger, the one to take it. A little under 3 minutes of rain. It's going to be a throw in. K-Dub now. Still on the ball. Still out here on the wing. Getting approaching goal. Back post. Finding the contact. Missing the frame though. It's going to be a goal kick now. About a minute 30 left now in the second half. Derek Eslinger with a huge hit. K-Dub still moving forward. Jeremy Crable able to shut it down. Taking the shot on himself. Not quite able to get it past Derek. Picks it up again. Under a minute now. It's maybe one of Tabor College's last chances to move the ball forward. Louis Firminger to Tyler Combs, trying to play it on to John Lee. K-Dub clears it out. A little under 30 seconds remain now. Darius Armstrong. George Zelaya to try and find back post, couldn't quite. 10 seconds now. That's gonna be it. Kansas Wesleyan 2, Tabor College 1. Thank you guys for coming out to the stream. That's gonna be the final result of the second half. Thank you guys again for coming out to watch this KCAC conference matchup. See you guys next time.